Hello everybody, welcome back to PHP MySQL course, and today I'm going to finish grade 12 converter. Let me remind you what we did in lesson 12. So in lesson 12 we basically finished the converter, but the problem was the result. The result of the calculation is displayed in a new page. I have to click back button. So of course I would like to see result immediately here in alpha input field. We know the functions, so using the functions we can make now the converter much better, much more professional. So let's take a look at the coding. Let me remind you, this is what we did in lesson 12. This is the form. It's a table, it's two rows. Each row is two cells. You have two submit buttons, but they have different text. So by analyzing text, you can tell in the processing script which button was clicked. And the processing script is long. It's just two long if-else letters. So one letter converging from alpha to grade, another letter is converting from grade to alpha. So the script is long, but it's very, very straightforward. Let me remind you how it's working. So I need to improve it. I need to put the results of my conversion into the same form. But first step I would like to do, so we are going to develop our web application in steps. It's going to be a few versions. So this is version number 3. I didn't change the form. The form is the same. So the static part of my project is the same. But in the processing script, I moved my if-else letters to functions. You see, I created function grade to alpha. It takes number, grade. It does all the analysis, and at the end, it returns back the string alpha. A second function does the opposite job. You see, the parameter is a string, so function is analyzing the string and then it's producing the number, and it's returning number back to the main code. So you see, because of the functions, my main code is much, much shorter and simpler. So basically that's my script. I don't have to right now think about functions. If we ignore them, you see how simple your main script is. If two alpha button was pressed, I call grade to alpha function, I show alpha. Otherwise, I call alpha to grade function and I show the grade. Let's check version number 3 if it's working. Form 3. Oh, it's lesson 15, so I'm already in lesson 15. So let's try. Yes. So it's working. From the user's point of view, nothing changed. From the programmer's point of view, I changed a lot. I created two functions and I simplified the logic, the structure of my script. And of course, I may move them to a separate file. I don't have to keep my functions here. So what I did in the next version, number 4, I didn't change the form, the static code, but I created a separate file. You see how it's done. It's just PHP file, PHP code, and it's just two functions. So I moved them out of my main script. And here I just include them. So this is very popular operator. You connect another PHP file to your script. So now your main script is really, really simple. Divide and conquer. Divide your code into pieces, into functions, put functions into separate files, and you are going to be in control. Besides, those files and functions may be done by your friends. You may work in a big team, and different programmers may create different functions, different files, and then everything is assembled together. And finally, I want to show the results of my calculation in the same form. Again, static code doesn't change. You see now version 5, the same, but in the script, what I did after I did the conversion, I didn't do echo. I removed echo. I just copy-pasted the whole form. So I just took it from here and I pasted the whole form here. So now my script does the calculation. It doesn't show me yet the results, but it does show me a new blank form. Let's test it. Version number 5. Version number 5. Yes. Yes. So I'm just one step away. I need just one more step and my web application is finished. So I'm going to make this as a function and I'm going to put alpha and grade inside input fields. So static code is still the same, final version number 6, static code is the same, but dynamic code is different. I created a function. I call it assemble form. It has two parameters, grade G and alpha A. And what it does, it assembles the form and it embedded the variables into value of the input field. So the tricky part is, you see, I go in and out. So I'm in PHP, then I'm going out, I'm in static, then I'm going in, I'm in PHP, then I'm going out. So you have to develop the skills to get in and out. It's a very essential PHP programmer skills, how to interrupt your HTML coding, go to PHP, and how to go back to HTML. Sometimes in order to produce just one PHP character, you have to do going back and going out. So you see, just to make curly brace, I have to go to PHP from HTML, I have to produce the curly brace, I go back to static code, and then I'm in the static coding. So my function assemble form accepts two parameters, and I call it here. So this is function definition or declaration, but here is my function call. And of course I could move my function here in the file to func, and this way my script would be even shorter. Let's test the final version number 6. Let's see. Yep. Yes. So the converter is working, and the results are displayed in the same form. We created a very simple web application, but now we used functions. We tried to create logical blocks, and we moved them in a separate file. Thank you very much for watching. Have a good day. Bye-bye.